Hello and welcome to our YouTube channel Amplicons of Biotech. In this video, we are going to learn very basic but important things about plant DNA isolation, that is, role of chemicals used for isolation. So without wasting any more time, let's start the video. But before that, if you are new to our channel, don't forget to subscribe. We will start with C-type buffer. C-type buffer mainly includes C-type, NaCl, Tris, EDTA, PVP and beta-mercaptoethanol. We will go through all these chemicals one by one. So let's start with C-type. Plant cell is enclosed in a complex cell wall and cellulose is a major constituent. This cellulose dissolves in surfactant or detergent which are amphipathic in nature. And our C-type is a detergent of amphipathic nature, which means hydrophilic head and hydrophobic tail. So by applying mechanical force which is exerted during tissue grinding along with C-type, or also we can use liquid nitrogen here, gets our job done. In short, C-type is a detergent which breaks down the cell wall and brings out the cellular components. Next is NaCl. NaCl helps to remove proteins that are bound to the DNA. It keeps proteins dissolved in the aqueous layer so that proteins will not precipitate along with the DNA. In short, it will keep proteins separate from the DNA. Next is Tris. When the cell wall and membranes are broken during tissue grinding, compartmentalization ends and the cytoplasmic material is released, because of which the pH gets altered and the stability of biomolecules is disturbed, which is quite obvious. And here comes the savior, Tris, which plays a major role in maintaining pH of the solution. Next is EDTA. EDTA chelates divalent cations. These divalent cations act as cofactors for many enzymes that increase activity of enzyme. For example, DNAs require magnesium ions as cofactor for its activity. And chelating magnesium ions with EDTA makes DNA's enzyme non-functional. And why we need to do that? Because DNA's enzyme degrades DNA. So in short, EDTA destabilizes the enzyme's integrity and prevents DNA degradation. Next is beta-mercaptoethanol. It is added in the extraction buffer to clean the tannins and other polyphenols. Also, beta-mercaptoethanol reduces the disulfide bonds of the proteins and thus the protein gets denatured. Next is PVP. It is only added sometimes in the extraction buffer if the phenolic compounds or polyphenol in plant sample is more, like in some woody plants, medicinal plants or mature plant parts. And PVP is mainly added to remove phenolic contaminants. Now comes phenol. Phenol is an organic solvent and so it is not miscible with water. And phenol is used along with chloroform and isoamyl alcohol to purify the DNA and to remove the proteins and polysaccharide contaminant. DNA is insoluble in phenol because phenol is a nonpolar solution. And on the other hand, protein has both polar and nonpolar groups. The bonds between amino acids are broken by addition of phenol and protein gets denatured and ultimately the protein gets unfolded. Next is chloroform. Chloroform is also a nonpolar solvent in which nonpolar proteins and lipids get dissolved to promote partitioning of lipids and cellular debris into organic phase and leaving the isolated DNA protected in the aqueous phase. Chloroform ensures phase separation of two liquids because it has higher density. Next is isoamyl alcohol. See, when chloroform comes in contact with air, it forms carbonyl chloride. So if we use only chloroform in our protocol, it will cause foaming or frothing, which will hinder the purity of DNA. And this is prevented when chloroform is used along with isoamyl alcohol. Also, isoamyl alcohol helps to inhibit RNase activity and isoamyl alcohol improves the purity of DNA. Next is RNase, which plays very important role in DNA extraction. Genomic DNA should be treated with RNase because to remove the contamination of RNA for DNA purification. Next is isopropanol. isopropanol or alcohol is used to precipitate out the DNA from extraction buffer so that we can wash away all the salts and other chemicals. Isopropanol dissolves non-polar solvents like chloroform. Thus, impurities from previous steps can be removed. Next is sodium acetate. The role of salt here is to neutralize the charges on sugar phosphate backbone of the DNA. Sodium acetate with pH 5.2 is commonly used in the DNA isolation protocol for precipitation of nucleic acids along with ethanol. And next is ethanol. DNA is washed with 70% ethanol, which is almost the last step of the protocol. And it is done to rinse all the excess salts which might have come along with extraction buffer in the pellet. So next and the last chemical is TE buffer or sterile water. Now TE buffer contains TRIS and EDTA. So TRIS is the buffering component here and EDTA is the chelating agent. So the TRIS amino is a constituent of TE buffer which has the ability to protect the DNA strands from radiation damage because radiation may break DNA strands. And EDTA has the ability to chelate the magnesium ions for what which we have discussed already here. Okay. So about sterile water, we can use sterile water for short-term storage of DNA. And for long-term storage of DNA, we usually prefer TE buffer. But be careful if you are using TE buffer for your dilution of DNA because the components of TE buffer and EDTA concentration may hinder your PCR or sequencing. For that, it should be diluted further with molecular grade water to lower the concentration of EDTA. So this was an insight on role of chemicals used for plant DNA extraction. If you want more such videos in future, please hit the like button and share this video with your friends, colleagues and whatever. Just share it, man. This is Meghraj signing off. See you in the next video. Thank you. Complex cell wall
and cellulose.
Next is EDTA. Next is chloroform. Chloroform is also a non-polar solvent in which now comes chloroform. Chloroform is also a non-polar solvent in which non-polar proteins and lipids get dissolved
to promote partitioning of lipids.
Next is isoamyl alcohol. See, if chloroform is used. Next is RNase. RNase plays very important role in DNA extraction. The genomic DNA.